This man carefully groomed, then put a rope around his neck. He doesn't want to live anymore. But as soon as he closed his eyes, he heard noises outside. Someone was driving into a public area. He angrily went out and scolded. As a result, the opponent accidentally damaged his mailbox. He has to help him drive into the warehouse. Then he returned to his room and resumed suicide. But as he hung up the rope, he saw that the neighborhood children in front of the window. He hastily stopped and hid the rope. Today's suicide plan has failed. He is a lonely, old-fashioned old man called Ove. His wife has passed away. Recently he was fired by the company. He was lonely, not bothered by anything, so he just wanted to go with his wife a little early. Today he carefully pulled the curtains to prepare to commit suicide. Unexpectedly the doorbell rang without stopping. It turned out that the neighborhood children had just moved in. He has to stay calm. The children's parents also came. They gave him food that they made themselves and wanted to borrow his ladder for a while. Although he was upset, he still took a ladder for them to borrow. Then an old woman wanted him to fix the heating system. It seems everyone is against him. He was very angry and chased them away. He is a mean person and does not like to interact with other people. This time, no one can stop him from committing suicide. He hung the rope up and kicked the chair. Before dying, people would often relive their lives. He remembers a time when he and his father were living together. His father rarely smiled at him. But once again he was almost hit by a train. His father hugged him for a long time. Old really likes this feeling. When he was growing up, he gave his father an admission letter. His father was very happy. He also showed off to everyone. But an accident happened. His father died. Old was only left alone, so he was bullied by other workers. The house was demolished and destroyed by officers. He became homeless who could only sleep on the train. Here, in desperation, he meets a woman. Her front teeth are a bit big, but when she smiles she looks like an angel. The conductor came to check the train tickets. She happily helped him buy a ticket. Old felt the love for the first time. He dated the woman to dinner, but he was very nervous. The woman thinks this man is cute. She asked Ove why he only ate soup, but not ordered food. Ove said his house burned down. He had nothing. Money in his pocket is only enough to pay for meals for one person. He has low self-esteem and wants to leave. But the woman suddenly kissed him. At this crucial moment, the rope was suddenly broken. Ove can't die. He wanted to hang again, but the rope was still broken. Ove angrily went to the mall to return the goods. The shopkeeper asked him how the rope was broken. But he couldn't answer, so he could only turn and walk away. Ove decided to change the way of death. He knocked on the door of the neighbor house, wanting to borrow the pipes from her house. He helped her fix the heating system, by the way. In her house there is an old man paralyzed. That old man is a friend as well as a rival of Ove before. Ove told him that he wanted to commit suicide. When Ove was about to leave, the old man held the pipes. He wanted to stop Ove, but Ove had his own decision. This time he attempted to kill himself in the car. He shut the door tightly. He will definitely do it. But as he closed his eyes, there was a knock on the outside door. It is truly unlucky that. Ove opened the door angrily, but accidentally made a new neighbor bleed her nose. She said her husband fell injured. She doesn't know how to drive, so she wants to ask him to take her and the kids to the hospital. Ove is still annoyed but agrees. At the hospital, the woman took her husband to the doctor and left the children to Ove to look after. The two bored kids wanted Ove to tell them stories. He said so vividly that the two children laughed happily. After returning home, Ove is still depressed because he cannot die today. Two neighbor children hug him. The scene was heartwarming. These things did not stop the stubborn old man from wanting to see his wife. There were always people bothering at home. He decided this time to jump off the rails. But someone did it before him. However, no one went to save him. They even coldly took the phone to video the scene. Ove couldn't take it anymore. He jumped down the rails to save the man. Then the train appeared. Ove turned his head and saw a child, as if he saw himself when he was a child. He remembers his father. This way of death will make his father very sad. At the last moment, Ove gave up. He returned home disappointed. He saw a woman throwing a stray cat with stones. Ove angrily scolded her. That woman left. Ove wanted to feed the cat because he found it pitiful. He took her food, but the cat disappeared. The next day, the cat sat at the door. The neighbor brought the cat into Ove's house and said that her daughter is allergic to cats. She advised Ove to accept it. Now Ove not only cannot die, but also has more jobs. But this makes Ove's life more meaningful. The neighbor woman wants to practice driving. Ove taught her by himself. But women are always frail. The horn of the car behind constantly makes sounds that makes the woman cry. Ove angrily cursed the owner of that car. At night, the neighbor had to go out. They asked Ove to look after their children. The neighbor's house did not install a dishwasher. Og silently washed their dishes. At night, he looked at the cat lying beside him, and suddenly felt a sense of connection. Og stopped a car from driving into a public area. A medical department official got out of the car. He quipped that Og was like a madman after his wife passed away. Og is very angry, but he can't do anything either. He missed his wife. He wanted to kill himself. This is the sixth time he committed suicide. He intended to use a gun to commit suicide, so it would be quicker. But he suffers from obsessive-compulsive disorder. If he killed himself like this, his house would be dirty. He sealed the room with plastic wrap. Then Og points the barrel of the gun at himself. There was a bell again. He decided to open the door. It turned out to be two former students of his wife. They were kicked out of the house by their family, so they wanted to stay at Og's house for one night. Og was angry, but kept the two of them in his house. The next day, Og was woken up by a noise. He saw the students making breakfast for him as well as for his cat. Since his wife died, this was the first time he ate with someone else. After eating, he took his cat to walk the street. The student guy and the neighbor also went with him. Og suddenly felt that he was no longer alone. Neighbors told Og his paralyzed friend would be sent to a nursing home. Nursing homes often rely on patients to cheat money. Og is very angry. He called to denounce the authorities, but it was ineffective. The neighbor asked him why he didn't ask for help. No one can bear everything alone. It likes he could not bear the pain of losing his wife alone. Og tells his neighbors about his past. To congratulate her on her pregnancy, they had a wonderful holiday. But on the way back, the car overturned into the ravine. Since then, his wife was paralyzed and unable to give birth. But she's still optimistic and strong. She worked hard to become a teacher. But many schools discriminate against people with disabilities. Og wrote angrily to denounce and install the disabled ladder himself. Finally, his wife became a teacher. Though she is usually assigned to problem teenagers. But she is very careful and responsible, training students to become talent. Og says she is actually an angel that God gave him. Og thought, maybe his wife wouldn't want to see him throw himself away like this. The next day, the nursing home staff wanted to take the old man away. As a result, a female reporter stood out. She told the curator that she had evidence of his crime of corruption. That scares him and makes him drive away. Og once again defeated the injustice. But this time he has everyone's help. The neighbor's third child is finally born. Og hugs the baby like someone he's very close. He suddenly felt a sense of warmth. He had no children, but the people in front were like his own. Og found an impetus to live. He is no longer the mean old man. He became more gentle and harmonious. On a snowy day, the neighbor noticed that Og had not come out to sweep the snow. Feeling unwell, they rushed to Og's house. They found that Og had fallen into a deep sleep with the cat. This time, it was a very peaceful departure. In the church, neighbors all came to see him off. This old man has helped everyone a lot and received everyone's gratitude. Og used to live alone as an isolated island. But while helping others, he found a new meaning in life. At the end of his life, he didn't learn how to die, but learned how to stay alive. The movie here is the end. Thank you for watching. Follow my page to watch more film review.